Hey, hello everyone. Oh, this is only beautiful. And today I am Wen-Ke Huang. Today I will tell you about grow out of nothing. The first Salesforce experience about importing LibreOffice into state-owned company since 26. The background is my company's gas station. Hey. Here I come from Taiwan, and I transfer from Dubai, then I go here, Spain. Here is my workplace. This is our training building. I work in the education training center. And this one is our residence. And maybe next year we will hold the 2020 Asia Conference in my company. And here is my job and domain. I am an education trainer and also I am an information engineer. My domain is e-learning. And here is I am Eric in the Asian Conference 2019. Take peek and take picture. Then I will tell you about today's topic abstract. First is origin. Second is process solutions. Third is result. And fourth is conclusion. Finally is future. And first one is origin. This is my company in CPC Corporation in Taiwan. My company's employees is about 16,000 people. And we sell petroleum, natural gas, and liquefied petroleum gas. And we have constructed 73 years ago. And in recent year, we want to solve three problems. First is compatibility cost. Because we don't want to buy or change Office software, just only the Windows version change. So we want to solve this problem. And second is record retention problem. Because our company is a very long life company. So our company has a record retention problem. So we want to notice this record to confirm in the future we can open or edit our important document. Third is provide ODF file for everyone in my country, for all people. Because some people in my country, they can afford buy Microsoft Office or commercial Office. So if we can use ODF file or our software to them, they can touch the government file. Or information. So we want to solve these three problems because our company is also a government company. So finally, we found the solution is LibreOffice. Now and it also called in Taiwan is NDC-ODF application tools. But importing to our company, we have three importing problems. First is habit problem. Because in my country, most people only know or only use Microsoft Office from their child. So if we, in my company, if we want to change their habit,
or they know the they know Microsoft Office. They sometimes will yell at you, they yell at you. So this is very problem. It's a problem. Second is proficiency. Because they don't know or don't use ODF software before, so they can operate very easily. So they can fix or learn by themselves to know ODF file, software. Third is all file problem. Because our company have 73 years, so we have much old file they made by Microsoft Office. So their format is DOC format. So
now we can we use ODF software, so we must transfer much old file to from DOCX to ODT file. So this is the most important problem in my company. Next, I will introduce you to
what
process solution
we try.
First is support. We illustrate benefits for our executive leadership. Here, for example, we talk to them so to in no use in our most employees. We suggest that you only use LibreOffice can satisfy their work. Then they will save a lot of money in my company. Because in my company have 16,000 people, and we estimate these people about 10,000 or 12,000 people. So and in my company, everyone install the Microsoft Office Professional. So here I show you in Europe. One Office Professional 2019 and 580 euro one set. So our company have 10,000 people cannot use Microsoft Office Professional. It can save a lot of money. Then for special use, we still recommend they still can buy commercial software, because we still need to keep efficiency to work, because our company must earn money. Then second is training. First, we plan a lot of course to training. Next, we found this is the wrong way. So we do the next. We do the divide and conquer strategy. We divide our employees to four groups. First is starter. Starter only, soon will be retired, or they suddenly use the Office software. So we want to learn how to understand how to use ODF software to open the document. Just read it, don't edit. Then second part is basic. They need the basic 8-hour reading skill. So we plan a basic course for them. Third is pro. Now, sir, probably this part is, for example, some people use like
a counter.
They use to very proficient about chaos. So they can tell statistic something. So we will plan progress for them. Then finally is advanced. Advanced is the our interior teaching group. So here is the list. I open the case because this is our company's C-teacher group. And we found our supervisor here. And our vice supervisor here. And we can see also Eric is here. And I am here. So you know why our company's success importing these things in our company. Because the leader will support our and close to us. And third part, we using the e-learning system platform to
do it.
First is e-learning. Here I will show you. This is our company e-learning platform. This is Eric's voice. In our company, we have this e-learning platform to teach 6,000 people. Because if we open the course, not everyone can participate in it. And we also open a
public discussion room for them
to upload a problem or some issue can discuss here. And many people send their message or problem here. Second is using live demo. And third is using knowledge management platform. Then fourth is assistance. We invite Frank to our company to illustrate the benefit to our employees, our leader. And we still find enthusiastic people in our company to push this policy.
But
when we use four methods to do, we still find a slow growing about the percentage of attached file use ODF format. And this is four methods, but slow growing. So we think what's happening. So we do the benchmarking marketing to Yilan County government, which is success importing LibreOffice in their company. They give us
three
critical success factors. First is three no policy, no budget, no buy, no install. It means Microsoft Office. And second part is enforce in internal we hold numerous seminar and all computer install LibreOffice. And third is all people take class. And fourth is official document only ODF. And finally is all system must support ODF format. And in external, our website offers Microsoft and ODF and support PDF. And finally part is we need executive leadership support and is strong support and strong determination. After we go to the Yilan County government, we found a big gun, so we pull out it. Then we found we used the 5 and 6 method. Later, we found we have the fast growing about the percentage of attached files ODF format. And the sixth method is in X policy. So in government company, the most important thing is policy. Everything is about policy. Can push every employee to push it, to learn it. So we ask the boss to enact the LibreOffice using policy and a system of rewards and punishment rules. The third part is result. This is the result about our enacted plan and KPI. And the document is about push item and assignment of responsibility. And here is this year's August. First part is department. Third is ODF percentage. Third part is ODF plus commercial office file number. Now finally is 1/2. Then we can see most departments have reached 100% or 90%, above 90%, and only one department not reached 60%, because their customer is they sell natural gas, their customer in the above, they cannot follow our policy. So we still seek some solution to fix it. And the most important thing is continue tracking. So let every department know this is true. Must be keep doing, keep change. Then finally is the conclusion. Actually, I already imported this ODF software 3 years. So I actually find all we have to do is deliver ODF correct concept to them, so they will learn by themselves, fix the problem by themselves, and so you don't worry about it. You just deliver the concept for them. Future. Something we still need to is We have two problems still need to fix. One is find some way to salute much macros that using VBA to make. This is using Excel macros. Second is building system to forbid to upload non-ODF format documents, because next year we have 100% ODF document policy to achieve. This year is 60%. Then forces need to keep doing and keep training and keep checking. Now keep fix all software to support ODF format. Then finally is keep transfer all commercial format document to ODF format. This since we need to keep doing. And finally, after this speech, I hope you can help some department or company to import their import LibreOffice to someone's company or to someone's mind. Be strong. Thank you.